My name is Alicia Michael, and I am a fourth-year graduate student in the lab of Dr. Carrie Partch. Our entire lab studies circadian rhythms, so basically your biological clock. So each of our cells actually have this 24-hour molecular clock that keeps time and controls many physiological processes and is coordinated to the solar day. Many of us have felt the pains of jet lag, right? This happens because those molecular clocks in your individual tissues are out of sync with the destination time and misaligned with the environment. We found a novel human gene that is silenced in healthy cells, but turned on in many forms of cancer. So understanding how disruption of circadian rhythms can give rise to or exacerbate cancer will establish a molecular link between the two with the ultimate goal of identifying cancer therapeutics. So I'm originally from Washington State, the Pacific Northwest. And I've always been kind of interested in science, and my mom is a nurse practitioner, so she's definitely had science in her background, but not a professor or scientist in quotations. And my dad is not either. He does heating and air conditioning stuff, so. I'm doing more biochemistry, so having bacteria make these proteins for me, and not just the kinds of proteins that you eat. Proteins are actually like these workhorses in a cell that do stuff, like all the stuff, basically. And so making the proteins in E. coli bacteria, and then like taking them out of E. coli and purifying them just so I have that pure protein, and then seeing how that protein like interacts with another one, and using more, like I was saying, atomic resolution techniques, such as potentially nuclear magnetic resonance, so NMR, to look at protein-protein interactions. So you use this crazy big magnet that spins, and you can get a footprint or a fingerprint, basically, of a protein, and then see how, if you add another protein to that you think they interact, where it interacts. So this is always kind of pushing my boundaries, which I really like. And also, you have so much freedom as a scientist or a graduate student or a professor, whatever you choose to do, because you have these tools, you have like this toolkit, and you can ask any question you want, and basically, if you have the tools to figure it out. And so it gives you so much like intellectual freedom, I think, which is super exciting to design an experiment, execute it, and get a result. You're just understanding like how life works, and you have the ability to do that.